Okay, gentlemen, listen, when I tell you to break, you take a step back immediately. Get your punches up, obey my commands, protect yourselves at all times. Good luck to you both, gents. Such love.
So a first 10 rounder for Fraser Clark. That's all they had to get for him tonight, really, against a credible opponent, an opponent that people knew, whose record you could look at and see credentials, and that's absolutely the case with Vakut. 43, his best days are behind him, we know that, but he's been in there with some of the very best names, challenging for multiple world titles against Vladimir Klitschko. He's only been stopped by the likes of Povetkin, Jarrell Miller, Martin Bacoli, Arslanbek Mahmudov more recently. Fraser Clark. I think the plan here will be to settle in for what could be a long job. Get that jab working, plant that jab, put the right hand off the back of it, build into the fight. Impose himself.
Yeah, and also his first time over 10 rounds, so you know, he wants to back these rounds, win the rounds, be dominant, be the boss, but also make sure that he's conserving a bit of energy, saving a bit, just in case this does go to 10.
Triple, quadruple jab a few seconds ago, then goes to the body with the left hand. That's exactly it, isn't it? He's got 30 minutes in there, potentially, but you can be aggressive, you can impose yourself, without burning energy, without going crazy. Big swinging right hand there from Clark. Back though, had the glove up, took that one okay. Again, just working his way in with the jab, shortening up the right hand. It's been a good start. He looks in good shape. He's settled at around about 19-ish stone-wise, between 19 and 19 and a half, and he looks better and better every time we see him. The conditioning is just improving bit by bit.
Yeah, looking to target the body here with the straight right hand.
Good right hand there from Vak. Nice and loose. That one got through. That came in at nearly 21 stone, which is a good bit heavier than he was when he was at his best. Clark looking to try and work that body. Final stages of round one. Jab, taking his feet with him. Good first round there for Fraser Clark.
I told you, yes. This guy, the right hand over and the left foot is all behind. The jab, right hand over and left foot. Please switch on. Okay. The double jump is worth it. Finish with the right hand over, okay? And keep shooting down to the body. That was good. That was good. Bro, he's on the way out, right? Just 3 minutes in the middle of the cross. That's all you need to do with this guy. He's already giving you the rat. He doesn't want to fight. Can you see it? Okay, come on.
Angel Fernandez in the corner there with Fraser Clark. Those two have been together since he turned professional. And just telling him there that Vak really has just got that kind of right hand over the top, left hook off the back of it. And that's what he really needs to look out for, but you do need to look out for it because there's plenty behind it. There's a right hand from Clark that sends sweat spraying all over our side of the ring.
Yeah, I think he's also said the double jab's good, but let me see the right hand now behind that. You know, body or head.
steps in with a jab, Fraser Clark. Little feint. Vax trying to use that lead hand himself every now and again, but to no great effect. Managed to ride that right hand fairly effectively, though, the pole. But he's got good distance there, Fraser Clark. That right hand cannoned into the gloves, but the biting point of it was good.
Back quite slow and predictable with that jab. I'd see Fraser try and time it and come over the top of it.
Goes down to the body with the right hand, then jabs to the head. Just trying to move that up and down. The point of attack. It's unlikely that you're going to take someone like Vak out with one shot. Single punch knockouts are extremely rare as it is, but against somebody this size, it makes it that much more difficult. So, as I said at the start, you want to book in for a long job, chip away.
Yeah, I think he's doing the right thing, Fraser, targeting the body with the straight right hand, hitting the jabs to the body. Just keep touching him downstairs every opportunity you get. Bring his hands down as well, and then, you know, jab to the body, right hand to the head will work.
Tries to get that right hand off on the inside. That was decent, right to the body. And then left hand upstairs. Again, just moving in with that jab, keeping his feet underneath him, and looks to try and lasso that right hand in around the back of the left glove of Vak. Welcome back to your call. Two rounds in to our main event here between Fraser Clark in the red shorts, Marius Vak in the white. And it's been a good, methodical start through the first 6 minutes for the home fighter. I saw him box here in WSB a few times, Fraser Clark. The five-round format that they used to have in the amateurs. Brilliant competition. Might be making a comeback. Italian fighter called Guido Vianello put him down once, actually, with a straight left hand, and he won't thank me for mentioning it. It was one of those knockdowns where he got up so quickly, it was like he was trying to pretend it never really happened. But he had a very good record in that longer amateur duration. Very good indeed. Good right hand there from Clark. That right hand that Angel Fernandez has warned about. There wasn't too much in that one.
I can't afford to switch off, though, Fraser, because, you know, that's two right hands he has thrown there back, and, you know, big man, carrying a lot of weight.
Every now and again, when he feels he's in range back, he'll just let it go, won't he? He'll just let it go, hoping that something significant lands.
Yeah, good lead right hand there from Fraser. That was a good shot from him. Sent the sweat flying from back.
That's a good right hand from Marius Vak. Stood nice and tall and kind of chopped down with it. And as you say, he cannot get careless. Angel Fernandez is making that point in the corner. This is heavyweight boxing. You are going to get hit. You just don't want to be giving anything away. Good body work there from Fraser Clark.
Good shot. Nice right hand there from Fraser. Needs to get a bit of room now. Maybe target the body. Good body shots.
The right hand was clever, wasn't it? Because he just dipped his knees, and with his eyes, he looked like he was going to the body and then went up to the head. He's banging away right on the belt line there. And Vak just looking at the referees, bang on the belt line. It depends what instructions the referee's given. If he says the belt is okay, then the belt is okay.
Yeah, I thought they were okay. I didn't think they were low.
He's just turning the screw a bit here in the final stages of round three. Nothing too dramatic, but...
He was putting the pace.
Exactly, he was just putting them together a bit more, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Sure what happened there. It was like one of those awkward occasions where you're walking along the pavement and you all just start moving in each other's way.
Yeah, those are the right hands that Vak was catching Fraser. So yeah, he can't afford to switch off with his own defences, but that was good. Landing the right hand and rolling out underneath. Under the left hook from Vak. You see, landing the right hook and then, yeah, rolling underneath the counter left hook. So good work for Fraser there.
Well, no one really wanted to give any ground there. And they're such huge figures, there wasn't an easy route out of it all, but the referee managed to get them to manoeuvre around each other eventually. There's that triple jab, and again, the feet are good. He's moving in with it, distracting Vak almost, and then going with the right hand down to the body.
Off of the left hook that time, Clark didn't manage to land it.
Back just shifting his weight onto the back foot, makes that jab fall short. He's not the easiest to hit clean. The referee just pushing them apart. I thought he might have a little word about that one. Back wasn't impressed, he felt it was around the back of the head. In round four, these two just falling into the clinch a bit too often, maybe.
Yeah, a little bit too much clinching here, both of them smothering their work. Get a bit untidy.
Referee just speaking to the pair of them about exactly that, I think. And for Vak, getting a hold of Fraser Clark and leaning on him, that's not a bad idea because it ties him up. It means that he can't really do too much to you, and it will take something out of him because you've got nearly 21 stone weighing you down. And there, Vak just pinning that blue glove of Fraser Clark on the near side there. You see that? You just see him clamp down with the elbow, pins the arm. Fighters will usually try and do it on the blind side of the ref, walk him around. As I say, lean into him, lean on him. Just old school him a bit. That's what Vak's trying to do here more, I think, in this round.
I think spoil, don't let him get in a rhythm. And run the clock down. It's kind of perfect for Vak. You know, that's where, you know, Frazier's got to be the one, though, to create that room. Don't let Vak get a hold of him and smother and hold and pull and drag. He needs to keep it tidy.
Okay, let's go down to ringside. Andy is with Jamie TKV.
Jamie, I'm not going to mess about here. You're not backwards in coming forwards. You're here because you want the winner of this fight, and really, you want Frazer Clark.
Of course, you know, down the line, I know me and Frazer are going to get on. It'll be a great fight.
What are you making of his performance so far?
So far, so good. I can see him taking his time. You know, it's a 10-rounder, his first 10-rounder, so he's taking his time. He's pacing himself well. But so far, the punch selection's been good, and he's picking the shots quite well, so he's winning quite easy. It's comfortable for him.
It's a bit of a chopping down a tree job in terms of Marius Vak. I don't want to put you on the spot, but if he keeps chopping down, could he fell this tree?
Well, if he keeps chopping it down, he can, but I feel like he needs to stay on the inside and take it to him. Keeping it at a distance isn't good for him. He needs to take it to him, go and take the fight to Marius.
Good to see you tonight.
Good to see you too.
It's interesting that, isn't it, what he said there, Matt, because if Frazer keeps it more on the outside, then he's going to win this fight and he's going to win it comfortably. But maybe Jamie's right there. If he does want to try and get the stoppage, he's going to have to get up a little bit closer, hold those feet a little bit more and put himself just slightly more in harm's way, I suppose.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that's the right thing to do just yet. I think he can land better shots at distance like that one just there. I think when he gets up close, he's allowing Vak the opportunity to grab hold of him, get into clinches, lean on him, you know, pull and drag and make it untidy and scrappy, where I think when he's got it at range, I think he's got the better straight shots, Frazer.
And just dipping Clark there as Vak tried to let that right hand go. Of the two of them, he's actually slightly the taller Marius Vak, but he doesn't box as tall as Clark does. Clark looks to use the reach that comes with his height. Vak, not so much. A decent combination, and then the right hand did just get through around the back of the guard, and again there, that's worked for him so far tonight. Working to the body, Vak just trying to clip him on the top of the head. Trying to lead off with the uppercut there. He was quite a way short, but just followed it straight in. So Vak didn't really have a chance to make him pay for it inside the final minute. Vak with his mouth open. Hasn't thrown too many in this round, but did open up there and got hit with a right hand for his trouble.
Yeah, Frazer nailed him with a good right hand as he came in there. Vak went to really committed to the right hand himself. Frazer beat him to the punch.
And it's those kinds of punches that can put a dent in anybody, really. If your opponent's opening out and you catch them as they're on their way in, as they're looking to throw their own shot, then you can hurt them. Otherwise, somebody like Vak is going to be difficult to get to, because he's pretty good at riding the punches on the inside. He almost just lets his body go kind of limp and just leans it right on you, all over you, but lets his right hand go there.
Shoot on the side, initiate with the jab. Yeah, that's what you need to do. Long shot. On the inside, hit the body and then upstairs. Don't just look for the right hand over, bro. He takes them shots, bro. If you go with the right hand over, go with the left downstairs. You have to pick something up, man.
Welcome back, heading into the second half of the fight. And that's maybe the most solid blow he's landed so far, because Vak was just looking to try and get his own right hand off at the time. The Vice from Angel Fernandez in the corner. Matt, was pretty much keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah, I mean, he's winning, he's in control. He landed a good right hand that we've seen there when he walked back onto it, but didn't really have too much of an effect on Vak. So I think, yeah, I don't think he's going to take him out of there with one shot. I think he has to just keep chipping away at him.
He's landed a couple of juddering body shots right at the start of round six, the second one in particular. You could hear it around ringside. Just dipped his knees and got full power into it. Maybe now just trying to tempt back into the corner. He's taken these body shots well so far, Marius Vak. We're in round six, four to go after this. He might start to feel them down the stretch. But no signs just yet. Solid right hand. Just leaning on a little bit there, Fraser Clark. He's working hard. Just possible he's beginning to feel this a little bit himself here, just nicking a few seconds rest possibly.
Yeah, well, it's his first 10 rounder, so he'll definitely be mindful of that. And like I say, he'll want to make sure that he's conserving energy. You know, he needs to do enough that he's winning the rounds. And if he hurts back, absolutely, put your foot on the gas, but you don't want to blow a gasket either and pay the price later on. So he's always got to make sure he's saving a little bit.
Again, a nice sharp left hand to the body. Open back up, tempt him to throw. And it's a hot night to be hauling 21 stone around the ring. Marius Vak just heaving the breath in there, but he's looking okay.
Yeah, I mean, he got nailed with some right hand, he got nailed with quite a few body shots as well back, but he's been around the block many, many times, knows how to get through the rounds, knows how to look after himself.
You press, you're a young fucking man, you understand? This man's on the way out. You know he's being confident, yeah?
Apologies for the language there. Angel Fernandez just making his thoughts clear. So six down, 4 rounds to go here. Fraser Clark was up at GB in Sheffield recently, just talking to the current team because they're off to the European Games. Soon that will be an Olympic qualifier, so very best of luck to them. All sorts going on at the elite international amateur level. The politics is fairly indecipherable at times, but that is an Olympic qualifier, and they've all got their sights firmly set on Paris 2024. Such a successful team that Clark was part of in Tokyo. That'll be hard to live up to, but they returned a good number of medals in recent Olympics. bang on the belt line. And again, Vak just shakes his head at the referee there. But as I said before, it depends on the instruction. Some referees will say nothing below the top of the belt line. Others will say the belt is fine. And they will tell you before the start of the fight. So if he said the belt line's fine and you keep getting banged on the belt line, then you don't really have any cause for complaint. Good couple of right hands there for Vak. And let's go with the left as well. Fraser Clark just leaning in. Bit of success there for the pole.
I wonder, is Fraser feeling the pace here a little bit? It's the furthest he's been in his professional career. And against, you know, the most experienced opponent he's fought as well.
There's that arcing right hand. I would say he will be, because in with someone like this, we've been talking about it at times, what Vak's really good at, you don't even really notice it unless you're really looking for it, is that when they're in a position like this, he's not really doing it at the minute, but he does it now, he just leans forward. He's not really doing anything, but there's 21 stone of him, and he leaves all of it on top of you.
Nice jab to the body from Fraser. Let's see the further right hand after that.
Just a feint with the jab and wasn't in any kind of position really, so just crabbed forward and took himself out of harm's way there. Final few seconds of round seven.
Yeah, Vak just fell short there in the right hand, but again, just a sign that Fraser can't afford to switch off.
Lands that right hand again, very similar to the one we saw in the previous round. Vak was just trying to open out himself.
Yeah, just getting caught with a few right hands there, and back then trying to put some shots together. So just a reminder to Fraser, can't afford to switch off, to stay sharp.
Próbuj budować coś, to będzie break, lewy, prawy. Patrzcie, jest blisko, mamy.
Go there and make sure you're fucking sure that you're not tired.
Apologies. Three rounds to go. The schedule for 10 in heavyweight division. Fraser Clark, Big Fraser on the left there. Marius Vak on the right. We were thinking during the week of the litany of top heavyweights who boxed at this venue, and it is quite a list. Lennox Lewis, Anthony Joshua, Tim Witherspoon, David Haye, John Ruiz, Herbie Hyde, Usyk, of course, against Joe Joyce in WSB. Nikolai Valuev, who David Haye beat to win his world title. Tyson Fury, whose younger brother Roman was on the card earlier on, put in a good performance. Big right hand again there. And Vak has managed to take them so far without any particular problem.
He's kind of smothered his work there unnecessarily. Fraser kind of fell in on his punches.
Just half gets through the guard. He's looking to measure it again there. Didn't let it go that time, heading into the final minutes of round eight. Well,
left on the inside there from Vak was a decent shot.
I think the jab to the body, right hand to the head worked well here, Fraser. I think Vak's wide open for that shot.
Right hand on the inside there, just dipped his knees as Vak came in. Maybe didn't land absolutely clean, but if it had, that could have been interesting. Okay, let's go over to the far side of the ring. Richard Rappaport is with Andy.
Richard, you've been in camp all the way through with Fraser. How do you feel he's performing?
I think he's doing good. He needs to just switch on a little bit more, making a little bit of mistake. But, you know, at this level, one mistake could be fatal.
It's a learning curve. The first time you did 10, or the first time you went past 8, what's it like? What's going through your mind?
I was a rabbit in the headlights. But, you know, you get used to it over time. And, it's just a normal thing. You have to go through these experiences, and then you get confidence, and you understand what to do and how to manoeuvre. But he's doing decent. He's doing really well.
And the fighter in you, at this point, do you realise that Marius Vak, barring something big, may well be a stayer in this one?
You know what? I believe he's going to get the job done. Good fashion, and they just need to keep switched on, and that's it. Simple.
Top man, Richard, good to see you.
Yes. So, a couple to go. And he's won every round here, you would say, Fraser Clark, so far. And the idea was that he would get rounds in. That's what they wanted for him. And they've definitely got their wish. A long right hand.
Yeah, you want to see him get the rounds in, and you want to see him finishing strong as well.
Well, he's just trying to get away with those little clubbing shots on the inside there, Vak. Jab went up to the head, right hand into the body. And Vak has soaked all of that body work up. Bit of discoloration around his right eye. But nothing too bad. Not a mark at all on Fraser Clark, who again just looks to let that right hand go. I think he'll know by now that he's not going to get Marius Vak out of there unless something spectacular happens. Checked his chin there though as he pushed it back into the ropes.
Beforehand, Fraser Clark and his team would, you know, if they were being honest, they'd love to get the stoppage to make that kind of statement. But in terms of his development, going 10 rounds is actually a good thing.
And that was a decent combination again there. Every now and again, Vak, who, as I say, does stand pretty tall, just sways a little bit under attack, but it's not been any more than that. And that sway at times is half him just taking his weight a little bit back and riding the punches, taking that little bit of sting out of them.
Think that Fraser's, this is only his seventh professional fight, and a couple of those fights he has had were non-events really, so he's had very limited experience in a stop-start career, so he looked at more, learned more in this fight than the rest of his career put together.
I think that's a fair statement, and I think
that this is what they wanted for him tonight. As you said, a statement stoppage would be great, but this was always likely to go down the stretch.
Three rounds, yeah? Three rounds.
3 minutes.
He's going to come, yeah? You not allow this man to get in the centre of the ring, yeah? Double the jab to push him back and keep him on the ropes. And on the ropes, two faces now, yeah? Two faces, okay? Jab upstairs, he downstairs. Jab upstairs, to the side. If he's here, shoot the arm. 3 minutes, jump. 3 minutes, okay?
Come on, I think this Angel Fernandez made him panic a bit minutes. There to start with, because he said three rounds, and Fraser Clark sat on his stool just thinking, hang on a second. Hang on a second. 3 minutes is what we've got remaining here. 10th and final round. Fraser Clark in the red shorts, Marius Vak in the white. Vak in fight number 47. Has been in with some big, big hitters. Very few people have managed to stop him.
Good shot.
That was a quality right hand. Just pulled back, bounced off that back foot, through the right hand. And Vak just gobbled it up. Good hand speed there from Fraser Clark. And it'd be nice to see him just, as you said, Matt, just finish strong.
Yeah, because, you know, if he kind of died to death in the last couple of rounds, it'd be a little bit concerning as you're looking to move him towards title fight. So, yeah, the fact he's a 10th round, you want to see him finishing the 10th round with, you know, plenty left in the tank, or certainly some left in the tank anyway.
Good combinations off the ropes again there from Clark. Digs into the body with that left. I mentioned the Vak is quite a lot heavier these days than he was, say, 10 years ago or so when he was boxing Vladimir Klitschko, but his fitness to fight is still there. He covers up well. He rides the punches well enough, and he's going to get through this 10 rounds, and there is plenty more work out there for him, I'm sure, if he wants it. Decent 1-2, just moving around the target there, Clark. Fired the jab off the back of it. A little bit of damage to that left eye there of Vak. It was taking some solid blows. Right hand got through there from Marius Vak. Fraser Clark just gave him an opportunity there. But he's not looked in any kind of trouble throughout the course of this fight, Clark. He's not looked hurt at any stage. And there was maybe a little bit of a dip around about round 7. But he's boxed at a decent pace. The punch output has been good throughout the course of the half an hour. It is very hot in here. Every fighter who's been in there tonight will tell you that it's been a different kind of experience. And there goes the final bell.
Yeah, you know, that's a big box tick. 10 rounds against a very experienced, crafty old pro. Been around. And like I say, he's probably learned more in that 10 rounds tonight than in the rest of his professional career so far put together.
As you say, just good to get that 10-round duration under your belt, and to be in a fight long enough where you need a bit of a second wind, it must be reassuring to know that that comes, that that's there, because he did have that little dip. It wasn't anything major, but then he finished nice and strong.
Yeah, like I said, I think it was around the 6th or 7th, and it was probably unknown territory for him. And yeah, he did dip a little bit, but he got a second wind and finished okay there in the 10th round, landed some good shots. like I say, you look at his career, it's been stop-start. He's had a few absolute non-events in terms of opponents being really poor. So, all things considered, I think it's a good day in the office for him.
And I'm pretty sure that that's the score we're going to see returned as well. 10-0 in favour of Fraser Clark.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 full rounds, we go to referee Mark Bates for the official decision. He sees the contest 100-90, declaring your winner and still undefeated, Big Fraze, Fraser Clark.
So our first 10 rounder completed for Fraser Clark. Hopefully he's got the energy for a few words with Andy. And we'll get those from him in a minute or so.